Living Seed Media brings to you God's Word, which is His comprehensive equipment for changing lives. May the Lord impact your heart as you encounter His Word. For further inquiry or counsel, contact Peace House, PO Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Telephone numbers 0703-036-3659, 0703-768-1198. Email address lsmedia@livingseed.org or visit our website at www.livingseed.org. Let us sit back and listen as the servant of God brings forth the word of life.
One, two, go. Yield not to temptation, for yielding is sin. Each victory will help you. To comfort, to strengthen and keep you. The Lord is willing to aid you. He will surely carry you through. One more time, ask the Savior. Ask the Savior to help you. Together, we have stayed long in the presence of God. God has touched our hearts in various ways, but we know that it's not by power nor by might, but by the Spirit of the living God. Will you ask the Savior to help you? Each of these things that God has put in your heart, God expects that something good will come out of your life as a result. Would you not like to ask Him to help you? You have become a debtor because these things have been deposited. Eternal treasures have been deposited inside of you. Ask the Lord to help you. Ask Him to see you through. Make up your mind to shun evil companion. Make up your mind that you will disdain bad language. Things that will make God annoyed with you, as if God has been wicked unto you. Make sure you shun it. Ask Him, Lord, help me. I am going, but you must help me. Each of the things that God has spoken to you, ask Him, Lord, it is possible. If it is not possible, you will not have spoken. Please help my life. Help me to make gain with it. Help me to make profit for the kingdom with each of these things. Help my life, Lord Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. 2 Kings chapter 4. 2 Kings chapter 4, verses 1 to 7. 2 Kings 4, 1 to 7. A certain woman of the wives of the sons of the prophets cried out to Elisha, saying, your servant, my husband, is dead. And you know that your servant feared the Lord. And the creditor is coming to take my two sons to be slaves. So Elisha said to her, what shall I do for you? Tell me, what do you have in the house? And she said, your maidservant has nothing in the house but a jar of oil. Then he said, go, buy vessels from everywhere, from all your neighbors, empty vessels. Do not gather just a few. And when you are coming, you shall shut the door behind you and your sons. Then pour it into all those vessels and set aside the full ones. So she went from him and shut the door behind her and her two sons, who brought the vessels to her, and she poured it out. Now it came to pass, when the vessels were full, that she said to her son, bring me another vessel. And he said to her, there is not another vessel. So the oil ceased. Then she came and told the man of God, and he said, go, sell the oil and pay your debt, and you and your sons live on the rest. May the Lord bless his word in our hearts, in the name of Jesus Christ. All through the course of this meeting, God has used various means to minister to our hearts. He has used songs, he has used testimonies, he has used messages from his word, he has used Bible study, he has used workshops and seminars, he has used various things to speak unto us. And now, God is giving us a commission. In this particular scripture, the woman, that widow, the Bible says, when her husband died, he left her a debt, and she had no means of paying it. And I tell you, as God has deposited a lot of heavenly treasures in your heart in this meeting, you have become a debtor. Are you understanding me? I know that it was the Lord that brought you, because he has need of you in this country and beyond. We don't know how far God is going to use you among widows, both in Nigeria and outside. Some of you, God's hands are heavy upon you. You may not know yet, but you are going to realize it as soon as you leave this place. You have become a debtor of the grace of God. You have become a debtor. And you have to pay your debt. But this debt is not in form of money or material possession. It is a spiritual debt, and it must be spiritually paid. This widow cried out unto Elisha concerning this debt. And the instruction God is giving unto each one of us is that tonight and from now henceforth, learn to cry out unto God for this debt that you are owing from today. Cry out and say, Lord, I'm a debtor. Something has been deposited in my life. I am a debtor. Father, please help me to pay my debt. Are you understanding? You will begin to, because the paying of this debt lies not in your power. Even if you carry the workshop papers and you call somebody, come, let me share something with you, and you are sharing it, if God and his Holy Spirit does not help you, there is no way that person will gain what you gained in this meeting. Because it's not by power, it's not by might, but by the Spirit of God. It demands praying. It demands crying out. Say, Lord, I am a debtor. I have come for this meeting, and the word of God has been spoken to me. Definitely, I have been touched. I cannot deny it. Lord, I am a debtor. Help me to pay my debt. That was what this woman did. And Elisha came and asked her a question. Tell me, what do you have in the house? And God is also asking you tonight. Tell me, what do you have in your life? Tell me, what has been deposited in your life? Where has God touched you? What do you have in the house? What do you have in your hands? When the Lord was sending Moses back to Egypt to go and deliver the Israelites, you know he also complained. He complained, he said, Kai, I cannot go. How will I go now? I don't have any power, I don't have anything. Pharaoh will question me. The Israelites will question me. I don't have any power to confront them. And God said, what do you have in your hand? You know that was the same question. Eh? What do you have in your hand? And what did he have? He had a rod. God will not necessarily overstretch you beyond what you have. It is what you have that he is going to use to pay the debt that you are owing. The man of God asked, what do you have in the house? But to my surprise, this woman said, your maid servant has nothing. Maybe at a second thought, say, oh, but maybe this small jar of oil, which means the jar of oil that she had was nothing to her. Are you understanding? You say, ah, this one, what is this one compared with the debt that I'm owing? So it looks like nothing unto her. He said, your maid servant has nothing. I would like you to note that what God has deposited in your life in this meeting, even though it looks very small, it is not nothing. Is it nothing? Is it nothing? It's something. However small, it is something. Even if it is just the arrangement of things that touched you, that is something. Even if the word of God has not touched you, maybe the food touched you, maybe the labor, or you watched some of the sisters laboring hard, and that's what touched you. That's something. No? Are you understanding me? Don't disdain it. It is something. But this woman said, your maid servant has nothing. Not knowing that it is that little thing she had that God was going to use to bless so many others and to pay her debt. As I said, we are owing a debt. We are owing the church a debt. This thing that God is depositing in our lives is a debt on your neck. You are owing the body of Christ a debt. And you are owing the widows, whether believers or unbelievers, you are owing them a debt. And what you have is enough. It is enough. When handed over to the Lord, it is enough to pay the debt. God knows how to multiply things. Are you understanding me? You remember the boy who had 5 loaves of bread and 2 pieces of fish. Because he handed over that little thing he had, God used this little boy to feed 5,000. The little thing he had was able both to feed him and to feed 5,000 people. Don't be selfish. Are you understanding me? What God has put in your life in this meeting, don't be selfish with it. God can multiply it to feed many more thousands. Don't dam that river. Let it flow. So the man of God said, oh, you at least you have a jar of oil. That's even a confession. That's good enough. Then he said, go. Borrow vessels from everywhere. That's the next thing. The reason why Jesus used borrow here is because vessels are not necessarily bought. You know that human beings, it is God that owns them, isn't it? The Bible says all souls are mine, says the Lord. You can't buy people. God is not expecting you to buy the vessels you are going to pour this treasure into. You have to ask God, let him lend you. Let him lend you those vessels. All that you need to do is to pour into them. It is God alone that can give you the widows, the human beings, the church pastor that you will sell this vision unto. A man can receive nothing except it be given to him from where? From above, not from around. From above. So the first thing is to first note that the vessels that you are going to bless with this little oil in your life, they are God's properties. And except you ask them from above, even if you are talking like this and preaching the scriptures correctly, they will not understand. They will just be wondering, what are you talking? Leave me alone, John. Have they brainwashed you? She will not understand because the Lord has not given you that vessel. Ask God, Lord, please give me widows that I will share these things with so that I will not die a debtor. Go and try it. You will understand the way of God. You will just discover that God will start sending some widows. Some may just come in form of counseling and say, come and help me, oh, see something that happened to me. Some may come because of their need and say, please, can you please borrow me Maggi there? And if you are wise, you will know that that's a vessel that God is borrowing you. Are you understanding me? That you can pour that oil into. Borrow vessels from everywhere. Which means, even you must live the correct life everywhere you are. Because if your own life is wrong, no matter how much God wants to open the door for you to minister to people, they will not listen to you. They will say, preacher, preach to yourself first. Is that not so? Your life must be correct. You must be a good neighbor in your neighborhood. So that when God wants to borrow you vessels, there will be nothing to stand against you in your life. Borrow vessels from everywhere, from all your neighbors, empty vessels. Borrow not a few. Do not gather a few. Don't limit the ability of this oil to fill all the vessels. He says, borrow not a few. And you see, when the woman did it, and she got those vessels together, and she started pouring, do you know that there is no limit to which she could pour, provided vessels keep being available? Is that not so? And you see, you know that the limit, the time when there will be no more vessel, is when Jesus comes. Is that not so? When the world ends. As long as human beings are still living here on earth, there is a vessel to borrow. Are you understanding me at all? There is always a vessel to borrow. And Jesus says, don't borrow a few. Don't limit me. This thing I have done in your life, I can multiply it. So that by the time you are going to heaven, there will be a train of widows who will line up behind you and start singing the song of the redeemed behind you because you have helped their lives. Borrow not a few. Don't limit the Lord. Be sensitive to the vessels that God will be bringing your way, especially widows, to share with them. And this woman did so. But as soon as the vessels she borrowed finished, what happened to the oil? The oil stopped flowing. As long as you don't see that there is no limit unto the number of vessels you are borrowing, when you limit God, the oil inside of you will stop flowing. The grace of God inside of you will stop flowing. So God says, borrow not a few. Don't limit God. Don't say, it is okay now. No. Keep on. In diverse ways, keep on pouring. There is no limit unto which you can pour. And the man of God now said, go, sell the oil and pay your debt. You and your sons live on the rest. Which means this oil is not only capable of paying her debt, it is also capable of feeding her and her sons. When you decide to pour out this way, even your physical needs will be met. The oil has enough potential both to pay your debt and to meet your physical needs. It has enough potential to feed you and your children, to meet all their needs. If you will face it very squarely and say, Lord, I will not waste this thing that you have put inside of me. So we are going to pray and decide and make up our mind and cry to God and say, Lord, I will not waste your oil in my life. I will not waste this deposit that you have put in my heart. I'm going to multiply. I'm going to bear fruit with it. And if you look at that oil, in Living Bible, I noted that the Bible calls it olive oil. And it's not olive mixed with another oil. What is the implication of that? I'm not talking about anointing oil, so that you don't misunderstand me. But I'm talking about the purity of the oil. Not a mixture of oil at all. If the oil inside of you is going to bring forth the kind of fruit that the Lord wants, it must not be mixed up. And that's why we have been crying right from the beginning of this meeting. Lord, whatever is not your will in my life, whatever bad character, whatever wrong thing, the sins that I've been committing, Lord, uproot it. Please forgive me. Make me pure within, make me pure without. It is in order for us not to mix up this pure oil. It is possible that the oil of apothecary will be smelling because of little dead flies in your life. It is possible that your own source of water will bring forth bitter water and sweet water at the same time. But God hates it. That's a mixed breed. Let your life not be a contamination unto the pure oil that God is going to be bringing forth out of your life. Let your life not be a mix-up of the pure word of God. Let your life not contaminate the holy gene that God is going to be passing across unto other lives. God demands purity. The Bible says, is it a good thing that the same source brings forth hot water and cold at the same time? Bitter water and sweet at the same time? It's contrary to God's expectation. And you are going to also pray tonight and say, Lord, you have dropped pure oil into my life. My life must not contaminate it. Lord, help me. Don't let my life contaminate what you have done. Don't let my life spoil what you have done. Adam's sin contaminated the genetic race of the human beings on earth. When the Lord created Adam and Eve, they were like God. They were created in the image of God. But the sin in their lives contaminated it. And so that's why we inherited sin up till today. That's the power that this contamination can have on the people that you are sharing these things with. You may say, she doesn't know that I am sinning now. How will it contaminate it? It's a spiritual thing. Your life can contaminate it. So you will first need to call on God and say, Lord, the change that you have created in my life in this meeting, let it be permanent. Let it be permanent. The sin that you have forgiven me, the sin you have delivered me from, the demonic powers that you have delivered me from, please, Lord, let it be permanent. Don't let me contaminate the genetic race of the spiritual widows that you want to make out of my life. And you will discover that the Lord whom we serve, who means business with what he is doing with our lives, is going to hear our cry in the name of Jesus Christ. So don't forget there is a deposit of God's oil inside of you now. And you are a debtor of that thing that God has put inside of you. God requires that you must be fruitful and you must be faithful to the Lord concerning these things. I'm praying that you will not disappoint God. You will not disappoint God. And the Lord will be satisfied to depend on you in the name of Jesus. To end it, we are going to sing another song. We are going to sing another song before we pray. We are surely going to cry to God, because if God doesn't help us, some of us will die debtors. And when we get to heaven to give account, there is nothing to do, nothing to give. We can't change any longer. And the end result, again, if you look at Matthew 25, the end result of the man that was given one talent that did not use his own talent, what was the end result? Hellfire. So it is possible that lack of use of this grace of God can end you up in hellfire. You must pray, you must cry to God, Lord, don't let me die a debtor. In five, I don't know again whether many of us know the hymn, but if you don't know it, I will again sing it as a special number. I know some of us may know it. In five, it says, fading away like the stars of the morning, losing their light in the glorious sun. Thus will we pass from the earth and its toiling. We shall only be remembered by what we have done. Only remembered by what we have done. Thus we will pass from the earth and its toiling. Only remembered by what we have done. Shall we be missed, though by others succeeded, reaping the fields we in springtime have sown? Yes, but the sowers must pass from their labors, ever remembered by what they have done. Only remembered by what we have done, thus will we pass from the earth and its toiling, only remembered by what we have done. Only the truth that in life we have spoken, only the seed that on earth we have sown, there shall pass onward when we are forgotten, fruits of the harvest and what we have done. Only remembered by what we have done. Thus we will pass from the earth and its toiling, only remembered by what we have done. God is expecting fruits out of our lives, even as widows, and we shall only be remembered by what we have done. There are certain people that die, and people rejoice. The Bible says when the wicked reign, or when the wicked die, people rejoice. But if it is the righteous that dies, people mourn. You will only be remembered by what you have done. Even over there in heaven, you will only be remembered and be rewarded according to what you have done while here in the flesh. May your widowhood experience not rob you of doing something while you may, in the name of Jesus Christ. It goes like this. Fading away like the stars of the morning. How many of us know it? Alright, that's good. Let's sing. 1, 2, go. Fading away like the stars of the morning. No. shall we pray together? I would like you to speak to God. You know already that you are a debtor of the grace of God, of the word of God that has been deposited in your life. Will you go on that day and throw this grace, this word of God, back at God and say, God, you gave me little. That's why I did not make profit with it. You will only be remembered by what you have done. You may say, I am too old. I can do nothing. Don't let the Lord hear you idly saying, there is nothing I can do. You can do something. We saw the elderly widow, Anna. She prayed continually. And she did something that she was forever remembered for. What will you be remembered for, my sister? Mama, what will you be remembered for? When will you stop complaining and face eternity with the fruits that God wants you to bear? You may say, I am not educated. What can I do for God? Education is not the matter. There are many people like you who are not educated. You can reach them through your prayers. You can reach them through your sharing. You can reach them through the things that you have. You can reach them with the word of God. Don't let the Lord hear you idly saying, there is nothing I can do. You have children, you have grandchildren that you ought to take into the kingdom. Why would you say, there is nothing I can do? Your widowhood is not an incapacitation. It is not. It's not a defect. It's not an abnormality. It's an equipping for the service of the kingdom. It's an equipping. Pray, talk to God. Lord, please help my life to bear fruit. Help me. You don't have to cut me down, Lord. Don't uproot me, Lord, from the kingdom. Whether in prayer or in sharing the word of God, Father, help me to bear fruit. In my character, help me to bear fruit, fruit of the Spirit. Make a difference in my life. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me, Lord. Pray, talk to God. Oh, Father. There are many widows that have never known a jot of what you are knowing. Many languishing. Don't disdain the little thing that God has deposited in your life. Pray, Lord, I must bear fruit. Your word must multiply in my life and through my hands. Help me, Lord Jesus. Tradition is the other. so attached to their tradition that they make void the word of the Almighty God. Don't ever imagine that God will spare you. Jesus condemned the Pharisees. He said, "You hypocrites, you hold tightly to the tradition of your fathers, and you disdain the word of God Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth. What betide you? What betide you that because of the tradition of your fathers and of your mothers, you will contaminate this holy thing that God has done? What betide you?" It's a terrible thing. It's a terrible situation. You are not going to pray, "Father, whatever tradition, whatever sin, whatever belief that I have held tightly onto in my life that will contaminate this thing that you have done in my life, Father, uproot it." Pray. Pray. Talk to God about it. If God does not help you, you are in trouble, because something eternal has been deposited. Ask God to have mercy on you, my sister. You mercy, so that you will not die a debtor. Let Him work in you both to will and to do of His good pleasure. Talk to God for your life. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Believe you that your word will be multiplied. You will give increase. What? Much more than what has been spoken. You will give increase. We believe you. We believe you. We believe you, Almighty Father. You will give increase. You will give increase. Your grace shall follow them. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. There may be some of you that are just coming maybe today or yesterday. And while we were choosing Jesus, and we are saying, "Jesus, I will go with you," you were not here. We have realized that it is better to choose Jesus, the source of all blessings, the source of all benefits, the source of all strength, than to choose the benefits themselves. Would you like also to choose Jesus tonight and say, "Jesus, I will go with you. I will forsake my sins. Lord, forgive me. I have walked in sin thus far, but Father, I will choose Jesus. Tonight, I want to choose Him." Are you making that decision? So that from here, even Jesus will choose you. He will go with you in your life's journey. As a widow, He will go with you. Are you choosing Jesus? Can we see your hands up? Lift it to God. Lift it to Jesus over there in heaven and say, "Jesus, I am choosing you. I lift up my hands to you that I am choosing you tonight." Is there anyone like that? The Lord bless you. Any other life? Yes, God bless you. Lift it very high and talk to Him. "Jesus, no more doubting. No more dilly-dallying. I am choosing Jesus. I will go with you. My life has been like this, like that before. One leg in, one leg out. One leg in the world, one leg in the church. But from tonight, I am choosing Jesus. I will follow you all the days of my life. Lord, forgive me my sins." I want you to pray. Those of you lifting up your hands, talk to Him. "Lord, take me, accept me. I receive you into my heart. Take over the control of my life from tonight. Wash me clean from my sins, O Lord, for I am full of sin. Cleanse me. Forgive me. Lord, please help me to stand with you forever. not depart from your word from now henceforth. Make me your child. Make me yours from today. It is only those that the Lord has possessed that will be able to possess God. Tell him, Lord, from tonight I choose you as my only portion, my possession. I'm no longer going to run after money. I will not run after men. I will not run after materials. I will run after Jesus. I will run after the knowledge of God. Lord, I choose Jesus tonight. I dare to choose Jesus. Help my heart. Help my life. Thank you, Father. Those of you lifting up your hands, I would like you to come out. I don't know how God did his work that tonight is your own night. But we would like to pray with you because God must have to keep you specially. It will take God. It will take the Holy Spirit. Can you stand up from where you are? Yes, please come out. The sisters at the back, yes. Those of you lifting up your hands, come out. We want to pray with you. The grace of God must go along with you on this journey. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, that even tonight you are deciding to do your work. To choose these ones, you are deciding to have them as your possession, as they have decided to choose you. Oh, Father, this is the doing of the Lord. It is not the doing of any man. Oh, Father, we are grateful. Lord, we are grateful. Oh, thank you for your doing tonight. They are choosing you. Father, don't depart from them. I would like you to pray as you are kneeling down. And say, Jesus, I will no more depart from your sight. I have seen something. You have spoken to me. You have touched my heart. Why would I depart from you, Lord Jesus? I want to choose you. I would like to go with you all the days of my life. Whatever is that sin that is making me to be in and out of Christ, please take it away from me, Lord. Take it away from me, Lord Jesus. Uproot it. Uproot it. Uproot it. I will no longer depend on man. I will not run after material things. Forgive me my sins. Oh, accept me in your presence tonight. Forgive me, Lord. Forgive me my waywardness. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Have mercy upon me. Make sure you mean it. Make sure you mean it. Make sure it is from your heart. And the Lord will take you serious. Pray. Speak to God about this. God is doing a new thing in your heart. A new thing. A new thing. A new thing entirely. Oh, a new day has dawned for you. Speak to God. Lord, I am willing to possess you. I will not run away again. I will remain in Christ. I will remain your possession. I will not put your name to shame. I will identify with Jesus all the days of my life. Lord, I run away from tradition. I want to follow your word. Help me, Lord Jesus. Help me. Ask for the help of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. I would like you to thank God because He has heard your cry. Open your mouth and thank God now and say, Father, I know you have heard me. I know you are not a liar. You said, anyone who comes to you, you will not cast away. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. I would like you to know that as you have cried unto the Lord has heard your cry. God is not a deaf God that does not hear. Your sins were the things that closed his ears before against your prayer. But as you have opened your mouth to confess, and you have told him to forgive you, God is not deaf. He has heard your cry. You have told him to take over completely every aspect of your life. God is not deaf. He has heard your cry. And from tonight, you will begin to experience that He has taken over. You have told Him that you have chosen Jesus. He has heard your cry. He also has chosen you tonight. So we are going to pray for you. I would like you to follow me with that prayer. And believe God that as you are going with Jesus. You are going with the Lord Almighty Himself. His presence shall go with you. In the name of Jesus. Father, we are grateful to you tonight. Thank you, Father, for your doing. Thank you for the work you have done in each of these hearts. Thank you for the conviction of the Holy Spirit. I would like you to just listen and pray for you. Thank you, O Lord, that you have heard their cry. Father, we are so grateful. We are grateful that you listen to the cry of the poor. You are not deaf that you cannot hear. We are grateful that you have heard our cry. You said anyone who comes to you, you will not cast away. Father, as they have come unto you tonight, please don't cast them away in the name of Jesus. Whatever sin that has followed them here, Father, we ask for forgiveness tonight. In the name of Jesus, we ask that the blood of Jesus, the blood that speaks better things than that of Abel, the blood that pleads mercy on our behalf, let the blood avail for them tonight in the name of Jesus. You said, whosoever receives Christ, to them you gave power to become children of God. Let your power enter into them tonight. Separate them from sin. Separate them from Satan. Separate them from evil. In the name of Jesus. If there be any yoke of Satan over their lives, any power of the devil walking over these lives, tonight I bind you. I arrest you. I destroy your power over their lives. Your covenant over their lives is cancelled. In the name of Jesus. They will no longer respond to you, O Satan. They will respond only to Jesus. Whatever sin they have been sinning before, sin will begin to smell to them. up in their hearts against sin from tonight. In the name of Jesus, they will no longer walk with the wicked people. They will no longer make friends with evil people. Separate them unto yourself, O Lord. Sanctify them by the blood of Jesus. Make them fruitful vines in your vineyard. In the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, as they go from here, they go with Jesus. May you follow them up. Beyond what we have spoken, may you speak unto them. Let your spirit walk within their hearts. In the name of Jesus. Plant the love of God in their hearts, O God. Lord, the word of God that you have spoken to them in this meeting, we are praying that they will bear fruit with it. They will tell others about these things. They will win souls with these things. Their children, their grandchildren will benefit from it. Their neighbors will benefit from it. In the name of Jesus Christ. There are elderly women among them. Father, I'm specifically asking for this one. That you will make them praying women. Prayer warriors. Women that will make fruit, that will bear fruit by prayers. And by their character. They will change in their character. They will live the life that pleases Jesus. They will please you all the days of their life. In the name of Jesus. Lord, for those others who are still young among them, Father, we are praying that sin shall not have dominion over them. They will do your will in their lives. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Father, we are praying that you will make a mark of ownership upon their lives. Lord, look at them. They belong to Jesus. Satan, look at them. They belong to Jesus. Your work in their lives ends tonight. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Lord, thank you for all of us that you have brought for this meeting. Thank you for touching us. Thank you for healing us. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for caring for us. Thank you for the food you have provided. Lord, we thank you for what you did. Thank you, Lord. Father, we are so grateful. Thank you for the fruit you have planted. Thank you for the grace that you have provided. Lord, we sat down from morning till night, every day we were not tired. This is the grace of God. Lord, we are so grateful. We ask you to take all the glory in the name of Jesus. As we go from here, Lord, I commend each of these women unto you. Let your grace go with them. Let your will prosper in their lives. In the name of Jesus. Satan that used to pick away the word of God from the hearts of people, you will not have power over this life. In the name of Jesus. Under the shadow of the Almighty God will hide you. The devil will have no entrance in your life. In the name of Jesus. Lord, as your people go from here, whether tonight or tomorrow, Father, we are praying that you will go before them. You will make a mark upon their lives. You will watch over their steps. Every evil that the devil has planted in their lives, on their way, we uproot it in the name of Jesus. They will go in peace. They will meet their families in peace. In the name of Jesus. Father, we pray, O God, that your blessings will abide upon their lives. There are many times when we come for conferences like this and God blesses us, the devil waits at home to scatter what God has planted. But we bind every such spirit, every such demon waiting for us to scatter from our hearts what the Lord has planted. We bind you and take you out of our way. In the name Jesus. Lord, order our environment. Order our environment. Direct our path. Help us, O God, that the atmosphere around us will be conducive for the growth of what you have planted. Thank you, Father, for hearing us. We give you all the glory. Take all the honor, Lord. For in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.